Chaucer's tales, the brutal feudal system, holy crusades, bubonic plague. Can't say that we've really missed 'em. So dark and barbaric, so dull and mundane, that was so Middle Ages, that was so Charlemagne. Welcome to the Renaissance, with poets, painters, and bon vivants, and merry minstrels who stroll the streets of London, a strum in their lutes, in puffy pants and pointy leather boots. Welcome to the Renaissance, where we ooh and ah you with ambiance. We're so progressive.
The latest and the greatest, we bring it to you.
Much ado.
Welcome to the Renaissance.
A modern flair.
See us in our petticoats and party gowns.
Our trendy beards we trim to look like swallowtails. We're called Elizabethans.
They're all a bunch of heathens.
Heathens heading straight for you know where.
While witches are burning and wars tend to start, we bring you moments of culture and art.
Culture and art.
Bacon with the chicken.
What's he making?
Well, I think he's found a way of freezing meat.
That's new.
Hey, look, it's Walter Raleigh, born a new world, by golly.
And he's brought us all tobacco, what a treat.
Also new.
And we have a list of writers who are always writing something new.
It's true, we do.
Like who?
Like who? Like Decker.
Woo!
John Webster.
Woo!
Ben Johnson.
Uh-huh. And Christopher Marlowe. Thomas Kidd, Thomas Middleton. Thomas More.
And our brightest star,
yo, he's the bomb, the soul of the age, the wings of the Elizabethan stage. He's incredible, unforgettable. He's just so freaking awesome. Shakespeare, Shakespeare.
If your name is Shakespeare, you're hotter than hot. But if you're any other writer, then you're not.
Oh, noble kinsman, that royal blood and love do bind. Seek now thine own succor and flee thy native land. To die today, 'twill not be dawn till dawn. Taddy, ta-dum, taddy, ta-dum. Oh, who talks like this? Nigel, why can't we write like we speak?
Yeah, I haven't understood a word in the past 3 plays.
Did I mislike you?
Robin, what are you wearing? This isn't a dress rehearsal.
Woo! Well, I thought it might help me get the character if I were to wear dresses and hang out in taverns and flirt with men. You know, research.
Nick, I have a question about motivation.
Yes?
Why haven't you given up yet?
Peter, this one is working. I can feel it. It's just missing something. Right here. Nye, tell me out.
Well, I did write something in my notebook last night. I thought it might be a good idea if King Richard contemplates his own mortality, but now that I've said it out loud, it just sounds stupid.
Well, let me read it.
It's probably terrible.
Give it.
No, like, it's terrible. Oh, God, it's terrible, isn't it? I mean, I don't even know you let me write with you anymore.
Nigel, this is good.
Really?
Yeah, it's really good.
Well, I put a lot of layers in it.
One suggestion. How about instead of tombstones, he says epitaphs.
Oh. That's so much better.
Ah, good one, brother. All right, everyone, let's try this. Take your places. Let us talk of graves, of worms, of epitaphs.
Oh, yes.
Make dust our paper, and with rainy eyes, write sorrow on the bosom of the earth. Yes. Oh, that is good. I'm certainly this might be the Bottom Brothers' first hit.
Pity we're going to have to shut it down.
What? Lord Clapham. What do you mean, shut it down?
Guess whose next production is the tragedy of King Richard II?
Shakespeare? Why is he doing Richard II? He just did Richard III. Who goes backwards?
He breaks convention. That would make him so awesome.
Oh, yeah? Did you see Romeo and Juliet? What's so great about two lovers who kill themselves in the end?
Oh, you spoiled it! I was going to be singing this evening.
You should. It's life-changing.
Is it? Let you stab myself, drink poison in the end.
Stop it! Stop it! Now, I paid for an original idea, and you will lose my patronage. No more money. Unless I hear an original idea on the morrow.
I think that means tomorrow.
If he quits, we're all out of our jobs!
Lord Clapham, please.
Write something original, like the bard.
The bard. Why is he the bard? He's a bard, just like I'm a bard. You're a bard. He's just one of the bards.
He's the bard because he does it all. Histories, tragedies, comedies.
Comedies? Name one thing if that's funny. Give me a line, anything.
Okay. On my word, we will not carry coals. For then, we shall be called coilers.
That's not funny.
Oh, God, I hate Shakespeare.
That's right, I said it.
No.
I do, I hate Shakespeare.
Why?
I just don't get it how a mediocre actor from a measly little town is suddenly the brightest jewel in England's royal crown. Oh, God, I hate Shakespeare. His plays are wordy, but oh no, the great Shakespeare. That little turdy has no sense about the audience. He makes them feel so dumb. The bastard doesn't care that my purse is getting numb.
How can you say that? How can you say that?
It's easy, I can say it, cause it's absolutely true.
Don't be a penis, the man is a genius.
His genius is he's fooling all of you.
But he is brilliant, what majesty flows from his pen.
His poetry soars like a sweet violin. God's own inspiration, like lightning, does strike him, and he captures my soul.
Aw, oh, jeez, you sound just like him.
Really? Thanks.
You should hate Shakespeare.
Well, I try to emulate Shakespeare.
Well, there's your problem. You're so blinded by the bard.
Such a pompous little man.
Why is it a problem to admit that I'm a fan?
Cause he's a hack with a knack for stealing anything he can.
How can you say that? How can you say that a man really knows how to write a bitch and play? You wish you could pen one. You wish we were in one.
I just wish that he would go away.
Well, that's not gonna happen. Because everyone I know says he is the greatest writer England's ever known.
That's another thing I hate about Shakespeare. Because all the twits who bloviate about Shakespeare and how they peddle about his great accomplishment. Well, la-di-da-di-da. And once they start their gushing, there's no stopping them. And then it's blah, 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 Shakespeare. And he walks in and it's ta-ta-ta-ta, Shakespeare. He's only going to say,
really, such a genius and a rising is divine.
And Rosemary, other name is such a clever line, and they're all woo, and he's all stop, and they're all yay, and I'm all eh.
I'm really getting sick of it. And oh, I hate Shakespeare.
I think by now we sort of know you hate Shakespeare.
Shakespeare. The way he feigns humility when all he does is gloat. The way he wears that silly frilly collar around his throat. The poster child for why no one should ever procreate. Let me make a shorter lesson, I will give it to you straight. Every little thing about Shakespeare is what I hate.
Shakespeare.
Don't hate.
Nick, do we still have our jobs?
Yes, we still have our jobs. It's fine.
We have not got paid in like 4 months.
Would everyone please calm down? Come back tomorrow, and we'll have a new idea. An idea. We need a new idea.
I still say we should tell our life story. Two orphan brothers, their father lost at sea, whose mother died of a broken heart. How you, at age 14, carried me, your sickly little brother, on your back all the way to Cornwall.
No! We gotta think bigger. We need to innovate. The world is changing. Nige. I recently heard of a man who has a toilet that flushes!
Really? He doesn't just dump piss into the street?
No. He pulls a lever and it goes whoosh down a pipe. And then into the street. But that's what we need. Something new.
But that's what you're good at, the big ideas. I'm really just a poet at heart. You are doing so much better without me. Am I a problem?
No. Shakespeare is. Why did I convince him to become a writer? I was just trying to get him out of our troop because he was so annoying. But now he's like this sun that shines so bright no other star is seen. Yeah. Yeah, that's good. Which is why we work together. So let's get to it.
Nicholas Fossum!
Shylock! What are you doing at my house?
Your debts is due!
Shh! I've had a little setback with the play, but if you give me another week, I'll name a character after you.
Too late! Shakespeare already promised me that! I can see it now! Psylocke, the really nice Jew. Here's a better offer. Cut me in as an investor and I'll cancel your debt.
But you're not a patron, you're a moneylender.
Because that's the only job they let Jews do! But what I really love, what gives me nuggets in my Bubik, this is the theater. I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it. I love the sights, the smells, the roar of the crowd, the splat of the fruit as it hits the actors. It's a temple to me, I tell you. A temple. Catholic, partisan, Jew. I don't give a rat's tookus. My religion is theater.
Wow. I had no idea. But I can't. It's illegal. If I let you invest, we'd both be hanged at Tyburn.
At least you finally have an audience. Take the weekend. Mull it over. Because on Monday, your interest doubles.
Hello, darling. How was your day?
Interesting. I went to the stocks and watched the mob throw cabbages at the criminals.
Why'd you do that? I thought you hate that stuff.
I know, it was awful. Boiled cabbage?
I think it's delicious.
Aw, thanks, Knight. There would have been meat, but the landlord came by demanding the rent. Took our last shilling right out of my hand. And then I was going to surprise you with some mutton. But sheep are fast.
Wait, you chased a sheep? You know what? That's it.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna take some money from the money box, because obviously we need it right now.
Ouch! We've been through this. We do not touch the money box.
P, we shouldn't have to live like this. You deserve better.
So do you. We all do, and that's what we're saving for. Better life. A simple cottage in the country for all of us. You, me, a couple of kids. A room for Nigel and maybe his wife one day.
Oh, stop it.
Now, I know it's been a while since we put any money in there, which is why I was thinking I should get a job.
What? No, no, you can't. If you get a job, that'll make me feel like a failure. None of the other writers' wives have jobs.
Well, they should. This is the 90s. We've got a woman on the throne, and by the year 1600, women will be completely equal to men. Oh! I just thought of the perfect job for me. I could be in your play.
What? You can't act. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
See, I can't act.
You know it's illegal to put a woman on stage.
And anyway, our play's been canceled.
What?
Not cancel, Nige. That's such a negative way to put it.
Sorry.
Sure, we're no longer doing Richard II, but only because we've come up with something new.
Oh, what is it?
Can't say. Don't want to jinx it.
So there is no idea?
No, I mean, we've had the idea that we...
An idea.
Then let me help you. I'll go out and earn some money, and that'll take the pressure off you guys.
No, B, listen, you...
No, you listen. Because I just want to make things better, and I need to know that you understand. If you ever got in trouble, I would be there on the double just to bail you out. If there's anything you lack, you know I've always got your back. That's what it's all about. Think of me as your sidekick, helping you whenever I can. I'm more than just a woman, baby. When the pressure's coming, baby, let me be your right-hand man.
But you're not a man. I'm a man.
He's not hearing me. If you're ever in a pickle, you can call for me and Quinkle be how fast I run.
But I'm not a pickle.
You and me should be a team for any dream or any scheme. That's how it should be done. Sure, I could stay in the background, just smiling every now and again. But just to be a pretty lady, that would be a pity, baby. Let me be your right-hand man.
You should probably listen to her. She's just been right. Eat your cabbage. Okay.
Can I just say I am stronger than you think? I am where you ought to go when the going's getting rough. So when things are going badly.
But they're not.
They kind of are.
Well, things are fine.
They weren't.
But it's okay.
Love?
What?
Ugh!
What?
Quit trying to protect me!
Can we please change the subject?
Not until I know that if you're ever in a fix and that's a fix you need to nix, then I'm your go-to guy.
You're not a guy.
Don't be so literal! And don't forget I'm not a shrinking guy, and that is solid rock. Am I? So don't be thinking I'll crumble when then you know what hits the pan. There's no problem that's too big. When you're married, that's the gig. So don't be a sexist pig. Is it asking too much of you? It's only cause I love you. Let me be your right. In fact, I'll show you that I'm right.
Whoa, what are you doing now?
I'm gonna get you boys some meat.
No.
Baby, I'm your right. Don't put up a fight. I can be your right. Starting here tonight, let me be your right hand. Man. Let me be your right hand man.
What just happened?
Wow, I wish I had someone who would do that kind of stuff for me.
I think it's sweet. It's humiliating. She goes out to town square to collect day-old cabbage to feed us? What kind of husband am I? One idea would solve all those problems. Oh, and we need it by tomorrow.
Tomorrow? I don't know if I can write under that kind of pressure.
Oh, no, don't go there, don't go there. Hey, breathe. In. Out. Why don't you get some rest? I'll see what I can come up with, and we'll start first thing tomorrow morning.
Okay. I'm sorry, Nick. I just... I love you so much.
I love you, too. Now get some sleep.
Okay.
God, I hate Shakespeare. But when I sit and really contemplate Shakespeare... I guess I hate the fact that he is everything I ever dreamed that I could be. I mostly hate the way he makes me feel about me. 'Cause the truth is, it wouldn't be that bad to be Shakespeare. In fact, I'd give my left nad to be Shakespeare. If I could only have one tiny little smidgen of his notoriety, it would relieve me of the pressures of responsibility. I've gotta make it happen, gotta find that pot of gold. If there was just some way to know just what the future holds. What the future holds. I need more than just luck. Hey, do you know where I can find a soothsayer?
No, but the knowing. Supposed to be the best.
Thanks. out of business due to unforeseen circumstances. Well, obviously not the very best.
Did I hear a need for future seeing? If seeing is what you need, then I can help you. If help is what you need, then I can see you. But if neither is what you need, well then, I can foresee you leaving very shortly. So, am I hired?
Well, I haven't...
Actually, I know I will be. I'm just being polite.
Who are you?
I am Nostradamus.
The Nostradamus?
No, I'm his nephew, Thomas.
Thomas Nostradamus.
I promise. But I share the same gift as my esteemed uncle, and for half a crown, I will share those gifts with you. And for you, I predict a new life with no teeth. That was it. What? Hey!
Thanks, but I'll keep looking if you don't mind.
Suit yourself, but beware of the sign of the black dog!
Black dog, black dog.
Right, good luck in the asylum. half a crown, you said?
What? Oh, excellent. Now, what is it you would like the future to tell?
Well, I'm a writer.
I knew that. Keep going.
Okay, and I want you to look into the future and tell me, what will the next big thing in the theater be? Or what audiences will be lining up to see?
Right. Stand back. Give me some space. Oh, in the future, the theaters are very nice. Cushy red seats. A roof! What? Unbelievable!
What? What is it?
That much for a glass of wine.
How about what's on the stage?
Ah, right, getting to that. Oh, what a spectacle! I've seen the future!
Yes?
The biggest, most fantastic thing in the theaters will be...
Yes?
Musicals!
What?
Musicals!
What are...
Musicals? It appears to be a play where the dialogue stops and the plot is conveyed through song.
Through song?
Yes.
Wait. So an actor is saying his lines, and then out of nowhere, he just starts singing?
Yes.
Well, that is the stupidest thing that I have ever heard. You're doing a play, got something to say, so you sing it? It's absurd! Who on earth is going to sit there while an actor breaks into song? What possible thoughts could the audience think other than this is horribly wrong?
Remarkably, they won't think that.
Seriously? And why not?
Because it's a musical, and nothing's as amazing as a musical. With song and dance and sweet romance and happy endings happening by happenstance. Bright lights, stage fights, and a dazzling chorus. You want to be great, then you gotta create a musical.
I don't know, I still find it hard to believe that people would actually pay to see something like this.
Let's say it's a Saturday night and you want to go out in the town. Got a lady to flatter who might give it up if you don't let her down. You can go see a tragedy, but that wouldn't be very fun. Or a play from Greek mythology. See a mother have sex with her son. You can go see a drama with all that trauma and pain. Or go see something more relaxing and less taxing on the brain. Go see a musical, a puffy piece releasing all your musicals. Where crooners crew, a catchy tune, and limber-legged ladies throw you till you swoon. Hoozahs, big applause, and a standing ovation.
The future's bright if you can just write a musical.
Some make you happy, some make you sad,
Some are quite big,
some quite small.
Some are too long, some are just plays with song. Some musicals have no talking at all.
Wait, no talking at all?
That's right, there's no talking. All of the dialogue is sung in a very dramatic fashion.
Really?
Yes, really.
So there's no talking.
There's no talking. And they often stay on one note for a very long time. So that's when they change to a different note. You notice. And it's supposed to create a dramatic effect. But mostly you just sit there asking yourself, why aren't they talking?
That sounds miserable.
Oh, I believe it's pronounced miserable.
Oh,
that makes sense.
And people actually like this?
No. They love it! And what's not to love?
It's such a delight, there's nothing quite like a musical. Oh, another vision! I haven't even told you the best part yet! Feel that fascinating rhythm moving to your feet!
What is that?
Feel your ass gyrating to that titillating beat.
Do you need
What's
help?
Happening?
Are you okay?
You slap your lap, then fingers snap. That's when you know it's time to tap.
Oh, what are you doing now?
It's called a dance break. Apparently, this happens in musicals as well. People on stage just burst a spontaneous dance.
Why? Does it advance the plot?
Nope.
Develop character?
Not necessarily.
Then why do it?
Because it's entertaining. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Chance.
Who's odds? Big applause with everyone cheering for us.
And for some unexplainable reason.
design. When dancers kick in unison in one big wonderful line.
And then you got yourself a music hall. A music hall. A la 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 la. The music hall. With splashy style and a big fake smile. So snazzy hands, some jazzy hands. I swear that I cross my heart, hope to die.
From me, they'll be flocking to see. Your starlet won't quit Big Hit Musical.
A Big Hit Musical.
And you're sure this will work?
Actually, sometimes it works so well, you do the ending of the exact same song again.
Again?
5, 6, 7, 8! Take it from me! They'll be flocking to see. Your starlet won't quit Big Hit Musical.
Okay, come on, Nigel. A big idea for a new show, or for a muse is fire. Whoa, I'm so sorry. I didn't see.
Is this a poem?
Uh-huh.
Are you a poet?
Uh-huh.
I love poetry and the way poets use lyrical language to express the beauty of life.
Uh-huh. Forster, come away from that heathen at once. Nigel, there you are. Big news.
Me too. I think I'm in love.
You? With who?
Her.
Oh. Wow. I guess a guy can only wait so long.
No, not with her. With her.
A Puritan? Are you mad? Do you know who her father is?
Brethren, I say unto thee, the theaters are a scourge upon our land, where men dress as women and kiss other men. I have seen it myself, and it did stiffen my resolve. For such sinful role play is a gateway to lustful desires and fantasies of the flesh.
You really want that guy giving a speech at your wedding reception?
Let not thy sacred soul be poisoned by the poets and playwrights whose dark inventions divert simple minds from the one true book. Come on, boys.
No, forget about her. It'll never work out.
Hey, so you know that big idea we've been needing? Well, I got it.
You have?
Yeah, but you're gonna have to look at it with an open mind because it's a bit radical.
Okay, what is it?
A musical. It's a play with songs, but the songs advance the plot and develop character as they seamlessly segue between dialogue and singing.
That is the most amazing idea!
Really?
Well, it's brilliant, actually. I mean, what better way to express the inner longings of the human soul than through music! And you're always writing songs on your lute!
I dusted it off and started banging out a few tunes.
Oh,
and all those poems of yours? They're your lyrics.
Whoa, it's perfect for us! How'd you come up with it?
You know what? That's not important.
But this is good, right?
Yeah, a musical.
I love it!
Just need to figure out what it's about. Oh,
Please don't say two brothers from Cornwall.
But why not? I think we should write something emotionally true, something from the heart.
No! We gotta think bigger. Do you think that the Bible was written from the heart?
I sure hope so.
Okay, it probably was. But my point is, Matthew, Mark, Luke, those writers were writing about something big, epic, world-changing. Yes, I got it! Oh, why did I think of this before?
What?
The most historical event in the past 1,000 years.
What's that coming up the Silk Road out of China? The Black Death.
Black Death! Woo!
What's that creeping around your pee-pee and your vagina? The Black Death.
Black Death!
Woo! The Black Death. It's gonna get you. It's the Black Death. It's gonna hit you with those blisters. Oozing like syrup. That pesky little pestilence is killing half of Europe. It's the Black Death. And it's coming for you. The Black Death.
Black Death. Woo!
The Black Death.
Black Death.
Woo! The Black Death. It's getting closer. It's the Black Death. It's getting grosser and it's making its way across England. Dangling won't be any good for dangling. It's the Black Death, and it's coming for you. Black Death!
Well, my lord, what do you think?
They're singing.
Right, that's what you do in a musical.
Yes. But.
They're singing about the plague! I know! Shakespeare would never do anything like it!
That's because it's a horrible idea! You're going to make me look ridiculous!
But Lord Clem, I can promise you everyone will love it!
And Nigel Bottom!
Here it is!
Almost everyone! Brother Jeremiah, to what do we owe the pleasure?
Pleasure is a sin, as is music which I hear emanating from this den of iniquity.
Den of iniquity? What makes you say that?
Hello!
As if the theater wasn't heinous enough, you've added music, which leads to dancing, which stirs the loins and promotes lustful desires, which is why we must see the theaters pulled down, for we cannot abide by such ungodly erections. As a magistrate, I have much influence with the masters of justice, so you listen to this, Bottom. If you continue to promote this filth and debauchery, I will see you tied to a post, begging for mercy as I give you the rod. Good day, sir.
That's it. I'm out.
What? But Lord Clem, you can't.
I'm sorry. These religious nuts just frighten me. I'm afraid I'm going to have to retract my patronage.
What?
Have a good day, sir!
No, you can't. Please, Lord.
I can't believe you just let that happen!
Peter's fine!
Oh my god!
Guys, please be quiet! I'm on it!
We just lost our patron.
Oh, no. Hey, breathe. In.
Hold it. Out.
Walk it off.
Okay.
Patron. do out.
Watch it, you doff digit.
Sorry, beg your pardon, sir.
Oh, darlings, buy you a pint, eh? Eh?
B?
Don't know what you're talking about, lad. Name's Johnny.
B, I know it's you.
But I fooled you for a second, didn't I? See, I told you I could act.
What are you doing dressed like this?
Remember that job I mentioned?
Uh-huh.
Turns out all the good ones are for men. And besides, I know you need help because you said I don't need help.
But the only reason I said that was because you got a job like this. Oh. Is that a bucket of crap?
Bear crap, to be precise. I've been promoted! This morning, I didn't have a bucket. And look! I already made a penny! I'm gonna go put it in the money box.
No! I mean... No! I'll do it for you.
Yo, bear crap boy!
Hear that? I have a job title! And one day, it'll be bear crap woman. Keep writing. I love you, love.
Nick, what are we gonna do?
Keep riding. I'll be back.
What? Alone?
Nigel, please. I need you now more than ever. I gotta go find us a new backer, which means... You have to come up with the idea. Can I please count on you for that?
Yeah, you can. Yeah, you can. No, you can't. Sorry. Good day, mistress.
Good days for those when lit with love till dusk of death did herald the eternal night.
Hey, I wrote that.
Yes, I know!
Whoa!
I accidentally took this after our first encounter. Your sonnet, it's perfection.
Really? You thought it was good?
It touched me in places I did not know could be touched. Forgive me, poetry is forbidden in my house, especially poems of earthly love. Oh, is there no pity sitting in the clouds and season to the bottom of my grief?
Romeo and Juliet, Act 3, Scene 5.
You've seen it?
6 times, you?
8? My father would disown me if he knew.
My brother, too.
I adore Shakespeare.
Me, too.
I have Commies of Errors, first edition.
I have sonnet number 1, signed.
Whoa.
I know.
Oh, that's awesome!
Well, I think that you are his equal, if not better.
What?
No way.
Oh, yeah. Well, you have Shakespearean sophistication mixed with the complexity of Daniel Webster and the sensitivity of Samuel Daniel.
Wow, you really love poetry.
I do. I really, really do. I love Sidney and Marlowe, and often I borrow their words to express how I feel. I love poems of mystery, fantasy, history, oh, with seductive appeal. At night, alone in my bedroom, satisfying my need, the candlelight fire ignites my desire to read. I hear the perfect rhyme, I get all tingly, because I know that to find a perfect rhyme is not an easy thingly. I love the places that words let me go. I love the way that your words move me so. No words have touched me the way that yours do. Really doing something to me, Mr. Poetry Man. Forgive me. I never get to discuss poems in this way.
Oh, it's okay. I just never knew poetry could affect someone the way it affects me.
Me neither.
It's the end all, the be all, the you ought to see all the books that I have on my shelf.
Me too. I find pleasure perusing those writings and musing. So often I pleasure myself. Wait, that didn't sound right.
No, I know what you mean.
when I'm deep in the throes of impassionate prose, I could scream.
You scream?
Yeah.
So do I.
Oh, I love a lifting line of lyrical alliteration.
Who doesn't love alliteration?
And then I'm like, whoa, when the phrases come together like a consummation.
It's sweet. I love the places that words let me go. I love the way that your words move me so. I love that you feel the same way I do. And I love, you know that I love, you know that I love.
Me too.
I want to show you something.
Okay.
I keep it hidden from my brother because he'd probably kill me, but it's a letter to me from the bard saying he's received my sonnet.
You sent Shakespeare a sonnet? And he's read it?
Well, he said he would.
You know him?
Only sort of kind of. I mean, him and my brother were in the same acting troupe.
Master Nigel,
I
am. An invitation from Master Shakespeare to be his personal guest at a recitation in the park.
Shakespeare? In the park? Can she be my plus one?
One will be one.
Ladies and gentlemen, all the way from Stratford-upon-Avon, the king of couplets, the sultan of sonnets, the man who put the I am in iambic pentameter, please put your hands together for the one, the only, William Shakespeare!
Discontent. Do it!
Now is the winter of our discontent.
May glorious summer by this sunny York.
May glorious summer by this sunny York.
Let me say glorious.
Glorious.
Do you mean me?
Glorious.
Well, I can.
Glorious.
Now let me see G-L-R-R-I-O-U-S. Who fits that bill?
It's Will.
Yes. There's a fever going around. Has anybody caught it?
We're shaking it for Shakespeare.
Thinks you got it. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Willpower.
I am the will of the people now.
Willpower.
I am the will of the people now.
Will.
Huzzah!
Huzzah!
Oh, that is music to my ears. And if music be the food of love, my heart. That's a new one, don't even know where to put it yet. Speaking of love, here's one for all you lovers out there.
Oh. But
light through yonder window break.
Yeah!
Thank you. It is the east and the sun. Rise, fair sun, and kill the envious moon. The moon was already sick and pale, so sick and so pale with grief that thou her made.
Yeah.
Thou art far more fair than she, than she.
So would you please consider reinvesting?
I am no longer talking to you. You already ruined Romeo and Juliet. Now I'm off to see Richard III.
Oh, yeah? Well, guess what?
Stop it.
Richard can't find his horse.
Stop it.
And then he dies.
Stop it!
Oi, new bloke, you up to this or not?
Oh, don't worry about me. I'm just as strong as the next guy.
B, what are you doing? I told you to quit this out.
I know. But they were looking for good, strong men to haul the stage away. Why aren't they ever looking for good, strong women?
Because some jobs are better suited for men. Now give me that.
Oh! Wow, this is really heavy.
Are you okay?
Actually, I was gonna tell you the news when you got home. You know those wild mood swings I've been having?
Nope.
Yes, you do! I told you about them! Well, there's a reason for it.
Oh, no. You have the plague!
No. I'm pregnant.
Are you sure it's not the plague?
No. Isn't it wonderful?
Yeah, yes, it's wonderful. We're gonna have a baby together.
Oh, Nick, you're gonna be a father! A family like we've always wanted. Now we're gonna need that country cottage more than ever.
I know, and I'm working on it.
So am I. Better get to it.
No. I'll take care of this. You go home and get some rest, okay?
Thanks. I love you, love.
Love you, too. I'm gonna be a father. I'm gonna be a father.
Oh, hello, Nick. Ready to reconsider my offer?
No, Shylock.
Because you're prejudiced against the Jew!
Not me. All of Renaissance Europe is. Besides, I have a Puritan telling me that my writing's the work of Satan and I should burn in hell.
Don't listen to critics. They're for Katka. Come on, Nick. Be a mensch. Let me help you.
I'm not that desperate, okay?
Really? You have no show, no patron, and your brother is at a private concert for William Shakespeare.
What? Oh,
Oh, I'm gonna kill him.
It's invitation only. And guess who has an invitation?
Shakespeare! Shakespeare!
God, it's Thomas Middleton.
Oh, when he's talking to Edmund Spenser. And,
oh my gosh, look who just walked in.
Francis Bacon. Oh, it's like all the greatest poets of London are in this very room.
Including you.
Stop it.
Is that a young bottom, I see?
Shakespeare.
Hi. Thank you. Hi.
How are you? Thanks for coming. Good to see you.
Oh, I want to talk to you. Not now, though. So, Nigel Bottom, playwright, poet, and prestigious prodigy. That was a lot of alliteration. Occupational hazard. So, Nicky Bottom's little brother, his secret weapon, all grown up. Who is this delightful damsel, this maiden fair, this feast for the eyes?
This is Portia.
Portia. Good name. This is happening. Just breathe.
Ooh. Master Shakespeare.
Oh, she's bedazzled. You like that word?
Yeah.
I just made it up. It's what I do. Let's drink to that.
Stop! You know, I think I need just a bit of a lie down, okay?
Okay. So, Nigel, what are you and that brother of yours working on? A tragedy? A comedy? A tragic attempt at a comedy? See what I did there? See what I did?
Actually, Nick doesn't want me to tell anyone.
Oh, God. He is so paranoid. Always has been. Even when I was a lonely actor in his sad little troupe, he was so insecure. Of course, with you as his partner, he has even more reason to be. I've read your sonnet. It's good. Oh, it's stupendous. I'd love to read more. Is that your folio?
This? This is a random collection of thoughts and lines I have.
Oh, would you like me to give it a looky-loo? What am I saying? Of course you would. I'm Shakespeare. Cue the track.
Shakespeare!
All the world's a stage. Line that.
Hey, you're not allowed in
it's
here!
It's okay, it's okay. He's my plus one.
Trust me, I have no desire to stay. I, thank you, am just looking for my brother.
What are you doing? I told you to stay put now.
Hello, Will. Gasp! Hello, Nick. Been a long time.
Not long enough. Is that my brother's portfolio?
This? Oh, go get it. Oh, you're so close. Oh, no.
He was just offering to look at my ideas.
Or his ideas, as they'd soon be known. Do you bite your thumb at me, sir? You got the reference. I didn't think that you'd
really
get it.
Quoting Romeo and Juliet. Yawn, pathetic.
By my troth, the tartness of his face doth sour the ripened grape.
Oh yeah? Well, by my troth, your grape
stupid.
Ooh. Such a clever retort, and you can't write a hit? No, 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 no. We should actually be thanking this man. He was the one who suggested that I take up writing in the first place.
Yeah, because you're a bad actor.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Oh, yes, you are.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Oh, yes, you are.
Take it back.
No.
Out of my way, heathens. Where is she? Where is my daughter?
Hello, Daddy-o.
Portia, you said you were in your room reading your Bible.
Oh, Bible, 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 Bible.
You dare cross me and corrupt my daughter. So help me God, I will smite these bottoms and smite them hard. Come with me.
Smite their bottoms.
Portia. And you are coming with me.
Let go of me. I'm not a child.
Then why are you acting like one? I told you to stay put. Now look what's happened. We're on the most wanted list for a deranged Puritan. And Shakespeare almost got your notebook full of ideas. Which, by the way, is the only reason he invited you in the first place.
No.
Why are you so naive? You gotta watch your back with this guy. Believe me, I know every trick in his book.
But it's all rather confusing. I just lost my inspiration and the love of my life. I have to get her back!
Nigel!
Will you reconsider my offer now?
You know what? Why not? Let's do it!
Really? Mazel tov! I love it! I love it! I love it! So, what will our new show be about?
Well, we haven't quite got that great idea yet.
Too bad you can't get a peek into Shakespeare's notebook, huh?
I knew you'd be back!
Really?
No. It sounds impressive, doesn't it? So, how goes it with your musical?
Not great, actually. We're having a hard time trying to figure out what it should be about.
Hair!
Hair.
No, that would be just weird, wouldn't it? Wait. Oh. Little Shop of Whores.
Really? That doesn't sound right either.
I know. Why is the shop little? Small whores.
Look, I'm kind of desperate, so I need an idea that is guaranteed to be a success. So, what I want you to do is look into the future again and tell me, what will Shakespeare's greatest play be?
Ooh. Are you sure you're willing to cross that line? Wouldn't you rather just come up with an idea
on your own? Of course I would! Mm. And I've tried. If I just had a little more time and less pressure, I just need one hit to get me out of this hole.
I must warn you, for this you will pay a great price.
I have brought every penny I own.
That's not what I meant, but
okay. Are you sure this is going to work? Because I have everything riding on this. I even have a child on the way.
Oh, which I predicted. Remember? A new life with no
teeth. Oh! Okay.
All right. Shakespeare's biggest hit. Here we go. Oh! I see it!
Yes.
Shakespeare's greatest play!
Yes.
The one that we'll be talking about for generations to come.
Yes.
And this play will be called...
What's it called?
Omelette.
Huh? Omelette. Like with the eggs.
Yes. No way. Nope. That's right. Omelette. Oh, another vision.
Okay.
Something Danish.
Danish. So breakfast theme?
Ham sausage, ham Danish, ham omelet.
That must be it!
Really? And you're sure this will be great?
It'll be known as perhaps the single greatest play ever written!
Oh, yes!
Oh, I'm getting a flood of images! So many!
Write them all down, every single one of them!
Let me go get my quill!
This is going to solve so many problems. I can see my future getting brighter. No more Mr. Anonymous. No more world that is Nick Bottomless. My name will be synonymous with being on the top. I can see it now. I'm the cat's meow. It's a hit pow. It's gonna be great, gonna be great. Everywhere I go, they will love me so. Hail my name, oh, it's gonna be great, gonna be great.
Master Bun, you're such a wonderful writer.
You really think so?
And your talent is talent beyond compare.
Why, thank you.
You're a star, you are, and could be brighter.
You're just embarrassing me.
You're a real visionary.
Thank you, Jesus, and Hail Mary.
This Bob's gonna be on top. This Bob's gonna be on top.
Never gonna sizzle, never gonna pop.
Yeah, this Bob's gonna be on top. This is heaven sent, feeling confident. Money well spent, it's gonna be great, gonna be great.
Throw a big parade, praises will be made. Compliments paid, it's gonna be great, gonna be great.
And baby are so eternally grateful.
You're who I'm doing it for.
Thank you for our cottage in the woods.
You deserve it.
If gratitude was food, I'd have a big plate full.
Nice metaphor, bro.
You're the greatest.
You demand.
I really should say it, but yes, I am.
This bomb's gonna be on top. This bomb's gonna be on top.
Once I get going, never gonna stop. Yeah, this bomb's gonna be on top.
Also a prince and a ghost. Murder most foul.
Write down everything you see, cause I see me, and I'm not just a bard, I'm the bard.
We are the royalty of the Renaissance writers.
I can see that.
Now we're handing down our crown to you.
I'm honored.
But then overnight, you're someone better than the rest of us. Now you are the best of us.
Not so fast. Hello, Will. I knew you wouldn't go down with that fight.
The top, sir. Nay, thou surely doth jest. I say, on my honor here, I doth protest.
Yawn. Rhyming couplet, that was so 1580s.
Oh, yeah? Well, if you want to make it to the top, then you're gonna have to go through me. Cause on the top is where I live, and I will not be giving up that easily. So there!
Oh man, I have been waiting for this moment for so long. I'm gonna enjoy it when I knock you off your perch.
No, you won't.
Oh, yes, I will.
Oh, no, you won't.
Oh, yes, I will.
Oh, no, you won't.
Oh, yes, I will.
Oh, no, you won't. My accomplishments are much more accomplished than yours.
In your dreams, I am the best.
You can't be the best because I am the best. I have written 12 plays and each one is a testament to my great skill. I am the will. And I wrote Taming of the Shrew and Richard III and Richard II and Henry IV and V and VI and Titus Andronicus. And oh, did I forget Romeo? And Juliet.
Well, I've just written the thing that the critics are calling the greatest thing they've ever seen. The people are loving it, can't get enough of it. Everyone, even including the Queen. She recently invited me to her cast where she lied to me. And Apparently she told me that you're not any good, not any good, not any good, not any good. And she told me that all of your plays make her vomit. And nothing's as good as my... musical omelets!
Wait a minute. You wrote... omelet?
Yes.
I never thought that I would meet my equal, but I concede I have been bested by the best. Maybe we could partner on a sequel, huh?
Oh my, how the tide has turned. Let's review. What have we learned? See, you were here, but now we swap. So kiss this bottom, I'm on the top. Well, I am. So let's raise a glass to Omelet, the musical. Bottoms up!
Bottoms up!
Starting to sweat, 'cause they don't have a story written yet. Welcome to the Renaissance. Gotta give the audience what it wants, but it's not that easy. And if your name is Shakespeare, you're feeling the heat to still be new. Welcome to the Renaissance. What's the famous
lunches and meetings and poetry readings and endless interviews. Gotta pose for a portrait, how I deplore it, sitting there for eternity. Then it's back to the inn where my innkeeper friend wants to name a drink after me. Then it's back to my room where I resume my attempt to write a hit. Just me and my beer and the terrible fear that I might be losing it. And it's hard, it's hard,
it's hard,
it's really, really hard. So very, very hard. Can't you believe me? It's hard.
It's hard.
It's hard.
It's hard.
So incredibly hard. So inconceivably, unbelievably hard. It's hard to be the bard. Honestly, I don't know how I do it. There's only so much of me to go around.
I got so many fans with so many demands. I can only go take a piss. Be a theater freak or the autograph seeker. I want a piece of this.
Give me.
It's the cross that I bear. I'm like Jesus, I swear. But I suffer through it.
It's a
part of the game. The trappings of fame.
So he does it.
I know. I gotta go and get back to my pen and ink. Don't make me do it, don't make me go through it. Can somebody give me a drink? Cause it's hard. It's really, really hard.
It's sexy, but it's hard.
This bar that I'm raising to be this amazing. It's hard.
It's
so annoyingly hard. So unavoidably, unenjoyably hard. It's hard to be the bar.
Baby.
I know writing made me famous, but famous is just so much more fun. You see, what people just don't understand is that writing's demanding, it's mentally challenging, and it's a bore. It's such a chore to just sit in your room by yourself. Oh my god, I just hate it! And you're trying to find an opening line or a brilliant idea, and you're pacing the floor and hoping for just a bit of divine intervention. And that one little nugget, that one little spark, then eureka, you find it, you're ready to start. So now you can write. Right? Wrong, you're not even close. You remember that, damn it, your play's gotta be an iambic pentameter. So you write down the word, but it's not the right word. So you try a new word, but you hate the new word. And you need a good word, but you can't find the word. Where is it? What is it? What is it? Where is it? What is it? What is it? What is it? Tell me. You know what you are? No. Enlighten me. You're a petulant little boy and a fraud. Shut up, mother! Sir!
Hello.
You asked for information on what Nicholas Bottom is writing. Our spy is here with news.
Did he see me losing it?
He's half blind, sir.
Oh, good, then he only saw the half of it.
See what I did there?
Speak, man, what news?
I saw Nick Bottom, I did. He paid a soothsayer to foresee what Shakespeare's greatest play would be.
Gasp! That sneaky little thief. Why doesn't he come up with his own ideas?
It's hard.
It is, isn't it? It's really the worst.
It's hard.
Makes me wonder why I didn't think of that.
It's hard.
Hard to alleviate the pressure to create.
It's hard.
Hard to do something as good as the last thing I did that was.
Disguise.
I can pay for his devious lies. I can do all the devious stuff, the work that's terribly and unbearably hard. All right, Nick Bottom, I think Shakespeare needs to find out what Shakespeare's next big hit will be. It's hard.
It's hard.
It's hard.
It's hard.
Fortune and fame, everyone knows my name. I can't help it, it's still freaking hard.
Okay, so just to make sure I have everything straight, we have a prince.
Prince.
Who's eating a Danish.
Yep.
And then he's visited by the ghost of his dead father?
Not a ghost. The phantom. He's the former king who was murdered by the prince's uncle. And the uncle's name is, Scar.
Scar.
Yeah.
And he murdered the king, and the prince is in love. But she goes mad, you say?
Yes, and how do you solve a problem like Ophelia?
Right, how do you?
The prince says, get thee to a nunnery. And then the nuns hide her, and all of the singing children, from the Nazis!
Uh-huh. And these Nazis, are they good guys or bad?
Not quite sure, but it feels important to get that one right.
Oh, they're coming.
What?
Okay, remember, stay over there and don't say anything.
Ah, the theater. I love it, I love it, I love it.
Shylock, just in time. Here, take a seat. We're about to get started.
I love it.
You haven't even seen it yet.
I know, but I just love being here. I'm verklempt, I tell you.
Nick, isn't it illegal to have a Jewish patron?
He's not a patron. He's a person producing money to get the production produced, so we call him... well, we haven't got the title yet. Can we just take it from the top of the song, guys? Watch him weave, Shakespeare.
What's that cooking on the griddle? Whipped up and beaten. It's eggs, eggs, eggs.
Woo!
Throw some fixings in the middle. So good for eating. It's eggs, eggs, eggs. Woo!
I see within this fluffy fold the scrambled nature of my soul. I'm cracking up as I begin to see the bits of me within this.
Omelet. Can I jump in here? In the realm of Hades is this?
I told you they'd be singing.
But they're singing about eggs.
It's a metaphor.
What?
What's the griddle? His mind. What's he thinking? Eggs. The symbol of life. But his thoughts are getting scrambled. He's cracking up like an egg.
Yeah, I'm not getting any of that.
Neither am I. And I wrote the thing. I mean, what's a fiddler and why is it on the roof?
Because that's where the chimney is. Quit overthinking it.
I'm just thinking about the audience. You know, the ones from Jersey.
Jersey?
In the Channel Islands. Next to Guernsey.
Oh!
A lot of theater goers.
These are salt of the earth people. They've worked hard all week. They don't want metaphors. They want good, old-fashioned, frivolous entertainment.
Cats!
What?
A whole stage covered with singing cats? No, wait. No, that's right. Singing cats.
Who's the nut job?
He's in the show.
What?
I told you, musicals need a big cast.
I'm sorry, Nick. I just have a strong feeling that something about all this isn't quite right.
What? What's not right about it?
This guy.
Well, yeah, he comes up with some of the ideas. You know, he's got. I don't know why he's meowing, but yeah.
Name's Toby. Belch. Humble actor from York. I come seeking an audition for the Barton Brothers.
Well, that's us.
Oh, what an honor. I hear tell that you two are creating something incendiary. Monumental. Bigger than Shakespeare.
You hear that? That's right. Toby, was it?
From York.
Well, Toby, we are working on something pretty special.
Uh-huh.
It's a play.
Yes.
Full of songs.
Yes.
About an omelet.
That's a great idea.
What?
I said, that's a great idea. Here's my head sketch and resume.
Hey, you've been in every single one of my plays.
Oh, well, that's because I'm a massive fan. And it's so unfair that Shakespeare gets all the praise and attention and the money. So much money. When your plays are in a class all on their own.
I like the New York actor. You're hired! Guys, meet the newest member of our cast, Toby Belch. Teach him the song. And where are you going? We still have a whole second act to sort out.
I have to explore some new ideas.
Let's not go through this again. I told you. This is the idea. Omelet.
I told you something about it doesn't feel right. Anyway, I have to write something on my own.
Wait. I see what's going on here. You want to go see her, don't you? Well, guess what? That's not gonna happen because you're staying here.
No, Nigel. Nigel, stay.
Stay. No! That girl!
Yoko!
Portia!
Oh, Nigel, you made it! I had to sneak out the window, but I don't think anyone saw me.
Are you sure you want to do this?
Yes.
Because we don't have to if you want to.
Oh, no, I want to. It's just... I'm nervous.
Me too.
Oh, so is here okay?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do people do it standing?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Ode to Portia
by Nigel Bottom.
Like Sarson saw the another scene, the heaven makes wonderful
design. Wow. Slow down. Oh.
Sorry, I guess I'm more nervous than I thought.
That's okay.
Let me try again.
Like stars and sun together, never seen, yet heaven may us want our flames to shine.
Oh, God.
Through night and day, no dusk or dawn between, and none can dim our light nor love divine.
Mm-hmm.
Astronomers, behold these starry eyes. Mm-hmm. Forbidden love, bid secret hearts beat loud.
Keep going.
And loss of man is our love denied.
Don't
and
stop.
Loss of nature is our love allowed. Into the sky will fly the elusive dove, to heaven's gate with my eternal love. I finished too quickly. I skipped right to the final couplet.
It's okay. It was beautiful. Will you write me another one?
What? Right away?
Oh, no, not right away. But Nigel, this is what you should be writing. Stuff that feels true to you.
You mean instead of omelet?
Ugh, I know. Something about it doesn't feel right.
Then don't write it. Write what you feel. And your words will move others the way they've moved me.
Will it move your father? Change his mind? He doesn't approve of us.
Well, neither does your brother. Does that make us star-crossed? That's so exciting.
Wait, that's not a good thing. We both know how that story ends with me drinking poison and you a dagger in your heart.
Well, maybe it doesn't have to. Maybe we could write a different ending. I'm tired of listening to the same sad story, how lovers fail because it's written in the stars. The feuding family plot is starting to bore me. I'm thinking we can show them that's not who we are. It may take a little more persuading for those who think it's better that we are apart. I have no doubt their doubts will soon be fading. We'll show them how true love finds a way.
Unacceptable. I do not approve.
But I know you'll win him over. His heart is gonna sing. And he'll love you when you do your thing. Go on, do it. Do it right now. Do it.
If love is love purely, then let me, oh God.
Go on, do it.
Let all
go on, do it right now.
Divine. Yeah. Good God, y'all. I see the light. You've changed how I'm thinking.
was blind, but you showed me the way.
I'm wrong,
he's wrong,
you're right,
you're right. Salvation is yours if you do what is true to you, and you do it with love.
I say unto you,
say what?
I say, who are we to judge these two?
So true, preach it.
He's a writer, he's doing what he can.
He's
the daughter of a preacher man.
Whoa!
And they got the right, they got the right to be together. Need no further proof. These words, they speak the truth.
And the truth will set you free.
It sets you free.
When you do what is true.
Wait, breathe. Oh.
Defy me, daughter of Eve.
Oh, Father, please.
You bid me grant so you could pray for forgiveness in church, and instead you slither off to Satan lustful desires.
If
love is the sixth,
silence!
Okay. You will tempt my daughter no more. She will be locked away in the church tower where she will stay until her brethren's exile in Scotland.
No!
Portia!
Nigel, write what you feel!
I will, I promise!
I love you!
And I love
you! I'm warning you, boy, you leave her be. Or you will pay dearly.
Portia!
Oh, what good is living when life is so cruel, and my destiny is to be fortune's fool? If my pen be my one and my only companion, let it speak for my soul. Let it speak for my soul. Sure as the day follows the night, sure as the sky turns to blue, this much I know, this much is true. Above all else, in whatever you do, to thine own self be true.
That's beautiful, Nigel.
Well, I haven't worked out all the details yet, but why don't we pick it up from the Princess Soliloquy? Peter, please.
To be or not to be, that is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against the sea of troubles. This is really good stuff, Knight.
Guys, let's keep going. Robin, from your entrance.
Oh, that this too solid flesh would melt, thaw, and resolve itself into a dew.
Frailty, thy name is woman. Get thee to a nunnery.
Hold thy tongue, fair prince.
The lady doth protest too much, methinks.
What is this?
Nick, your little brother has written something truly amazing. It's better than...
It's better than Shakespeare.
Is it?
Yeah. You wrote something, and you didn't run it by me first?
Nick, just hear me out. You gave me all these insane ideas. Now, I took the ones that actually make sense. I wrote something that rings true in here.
Oh, no.
Please don't. Just listen to me. It's about a prince, and he's not eating a Danish. He is Danish. And his heart is so full of anguish from a great loss that he realizes his own life has no meaning. He's so depressed, he wants to kill himself, but he can't even make up his mind about that. And then his true love is forced into religious exile where she probably dies of a broken heart. And then he descends into madness, and then he dies, and everyone dies, and the whole stage is full of bodies and blood and death, and they're all left with silence. They're all left to die, to sleep perchance, to dream.
That's the great idea. This has nothing to do with eggs.
That's what's missing. Why don't I collect these pages and hold them for safekeeping?
Nick, I'm worried you're not thinking clearly. But please, just read it.
I am reading. And where is the omelet?
There is no omelet.
What do you mean there's no omelet? There has to be an omelet. It's called omelet.
Why?
It just does, okay? You're gonna have to trust me on this one.
He's not hearing me.
Just read him what you wrote, Nigel.
Why? He won't listen.
I should really take this before this turns ugly.
Hey, just read it. Okay, so something happened last night, and I promised to write what I feel. Here it is. Short as the day follows the night, short as the sky turns to blue, this much I know, this much is true, above all else and whatever you do, to thine own self.
And good advice.
I don't know. I thought the whole breakfast thing was really strong.
Everyone loves breakfast. Exactly. But there's no ham. There's no eggs. You're completely ignoring the theme.
I'm ignoring the breakfast theme because that's ridiculous.
Oh, so my ideas are wrong. But this whole chew to yourself thing is right.
It's not just a line. It's what I believe.
Then you are a fool if you think life is just as simple as that.
I do.
Okay, well, I don't.
This is hopeless.
You should really listen to him, Nick. Honestly, it just makes your heart, which makes your heart want to soar.
Short as the day follows the night, short as the sky turns to blue, this much I know, this much is true, above all else, whatever you do, to thine own self.
Omelet.
Wow. What happened to my brother who had integrity, who inspired me to become a writer?
He finally has a good idea. And I can tell you for a fact that will be known as perhaps the single greatest play ever written.
How could you possibly know that?
I just do, okay? Now, we don't have time for this. We open in 2 weeks. Are you going to help me write omelets? Or not.
No.
No?
I can't. It doesn't feel right. And deep down, I know it doesn't feel right for you either.
It must be so nice to always do what you feel. Because you have no one to take care of but yourself. And
That's why. And everyone write that savvy brother who carried you from Cornwall story. Because I'm still carrying you. And I'm sick of it. Then why don't I just get off your back?
Nick, there you are. I've got news. Your musical Omelette, we're not selling any tickets.
What?
Because we sold out! They lined up around the block. Look.
Guys.
What audiences will be lining up to see? Told you. So what'll it be, guys? Do you want to be in something majestic and artistic? Or do you want to be in a massive hit that'll actually pay you? So let's give the audiences what they're hungry for. Omelette the Musical. We're on our way to glory. We'll play for kings and queens. And there and then you'll see the end. We'll justify the means.
Justify the means. Sure as the day follows the night.
Surely we must see this through.
Okay, say so.
Damned if I don't.
No.
Damned if I do.
Yeah.
But man, I don't have the luxury to hang all my hope on some simplistic trope like to thine own self
be true.
Oh God, I hope what he said is true.
Get a chance to read all of what you wrote, but I'll happily do it now.
Why? I think good thoughts while others write good words.
Good line, that.
Right? Because I didn't write it.
Shakespeare did.
Right, well, Shakespeare, you really admire him, don't you? Right, well, I'll leave you in peace, huh?
Okay.
Oh, Portia, I did what you said, and look what happened. Now you're gone, and my brother hates me.
Nigel? It's Will! What a complete and utter coincidence. Gasp! And is that the Bottom Brothers' new play?
No, this is just something I tried to write on my own.
May I?
What?
Yeah, of course.
When sorrows come, they come not single spies, but in battalions. God.
Oh, God, is it that bad?
No, it's... It's just... to be or not to be. What a piece of work is, man. It's a lot of cliches, Nigel. And
Haley, that's been done?
Oh. And as your friend, I will take a look at these and see if there is anything here that can be salvaged. But I do not want to see your name anywhere near this, but your musical. Omelette? I've told everyone I know. They simply must go and see it!
Really? But it's so...
Bold! Daring.
A lesser writer might shy away. Would you?
Write your omelette. Not this. That. Forget this. Write that.
Write your omelette?
get your omelet.
Oh my God.
The ladies just threw me a party and gave me the sweetest gift for the baby. Look what Helena got me to help the baby sleep.
Whiskey.
Isn't that thoughtful? And Miranda gave me this to help with the delivery. It's a stick to bite on. Yeah, that's gonna hurt. Hey, how's the show going?
You should probably just ask Nick.
I'll catch up with you later. Hey, what's wrong?
We got in a fight, and he said something. He said that he's still carrying me.
Oh, no.
I know it. Really hurt. I don't think we should ride together anymore.
Do you know the poem, Love is a Hell of a Lot of Work?
No.
That's because the poets never write about what love is really like. Try being married for 10 years. It's not all summer's day and sweet-smelling roses. It's more like, shall I compare thee to a horse's ass? Look, I'll admit, I've never seen him like this. He's under a lot of pressure and doing some really stupid things. Keeping stuff to himself, saying hurtful things, taking all of our savings from the money box.
What?
Yeah. Not sure how that love poem is gonna end. But what keeps us from walking out on him? I think it's because you know, like I know. If you ever got in trouble, he would be there on the double just to bail you out. If there's anything you lack, you know he's always got your back. That's what he's all about. He has his faults, but he means well, and he always does the best that he can. But it should be understood, I wouldn't change him if I could, 'cause I know his heart is good, and he'll always be alright. And man, he can't do this without you. Maybe you need to carry him for a bit.
Okay, I will.
Great. I can't wait to see what you two come up with. I'm sure you'll give them a show they'll never forget.
Alas, poor yoke, I know thee well. There's something rotten. There's something rotten. You can tell it, you can smell. There's something rotten. Now the kingdom is shot and it's all got to pot. Heaven help us, there is something rotten. Frailty, thy name is Egg. How like thee I am. For I am what I am, and what I am doth be an illusion.
You beckon, my lord.
Where is McCavity?
At the Jellicle Ball. He won't come.
Go and fetch him.
Alas, my lord, what vexes thee?
I dreamed a dream, Tom, an impossible dream. There were wheels upon yon dream, and raindrops on Rosencrantz, and whiskers on his kittens.
What be the meaning of it?
We've got trouble.
Trouble?
Trouble, I say, for my father lies dead, and the sermon that did sing him. Now where's the crown? Where is McCavity?
McCavity's not there.
Zounds!
My queen!
Oh, what a ball! I could have danced all night long!
Gentle prince, thine absence does worrisome for the king and I.
If Mama was not married, t'would not be so!
Oh. Where be the king?
Gentle fellas, what news?
The Nazis have arrived!
The Nazis?
Huzzah!
Oh, oh, oh,
good. The Nazis are such good men, one and all. And with their succor, we shall make war against the Puerto Ricans.
Tonight!
Oh, look, be a lady tonight. He wears a crown that should don my head. God, I hope I get it.
Fair guests. Welcome. Bienvenue. Welcome. The wedding breakfast is served. Yep.
My father newly dead, and the funeral boiled eggs now coldly furnished forth the marriage table. Methinks another chef might have whisked our desperate eggs together as one.
Pray, nephew, what dost thou mean?
Well, I'll tell you. The fruit of life can't always taste like sweet persimmons. Sometimes it's hard to swallow, I'm afraid. But when life has handed you some lemons, then handed back a mug of lemonade. My father said this to me,
that he did, and then he blew me
away with wisdom simple and concise. He said, Egbert, life is merely what you make of it. So heed this sound advice. You make wine from sour grapes. You got a flat pancake. Hey, got a crepe. When life gives you eggs, make an omelet. You get cola from a nut. A dirty worm makes silk from out of its butt. When life gives you eggs, make an omelet, omelet.
The solution to your troubles is cheese and vegetables and bacon, bacon, omelet, yeah.
When it looks like you should quit, find another way of looking at it.
When life gives you eggs, you gotta make that.
Troubles right here in River City,
Shapoopy, Chicago,
omelet, yeah!
When it looks like you should quit, find another way of looking at it. When life gives you eggs, just a great big bowl of eggs. When life gives you eggs, you gotta make that omelet. That's how you make an omelet. That's how you make a...
Ah!
though this may sound like madness, there be method in it. Simple truth.
Can I interrupt it? I have a question.
Fair Uncle Scar, why dost thou speakest when thou shouldst speakest?
Because I want to know, how canst thou make an omelette when one of the eggs be rotten? And therein lies the rub. The rotten one is you.
Toby?
Or not Toby? That is the question.
Will? Shakespeare?
You little snake.
And you said I was a bad actor. You will not make a mockery of me.
Oh, no need. You've done a fine job on your own.
Nick, what's going on?
Allow me to explain. Since Master Bottom's plots are difficult to follow. This man is a soothsayer.
No. Oh, I knew it!
Right? And he was hired by this man, who paid him to look into the future and steal my greatest idea, though I can't believe I've come up with this crap.
Nick, is this true? Guys, I can't explain.
You lied to me?
You wouldn't understand.
No.
I wouldn't. Where's everybody going? No, the party just started. Not the last omelette. Well, my work here is done. Oh. Nice try, Nicky. Yeah. That just happened.
I have failed in every way. I could have told you this would have happened, but you wouldn't have listened.
No. You told me I would have to pay a great price. And now, I have to pay for it.
My lord, at this vile and offensive production. It is my duty as a magistrate, and more importantly, my duty to God, to have him arrested for blasphemy, treason, employment of a Jew, witchcraft, and provocative parading of eggs. And for such offenses, the law demands beheading!
Defendants, do you have a lawyer present?
No, Your Honor.
Correction! I am their lawyer. And I say beheading this man would be redundant. Clearly the fool has lost his head already. Be more specific, I shall. Did you take the money from the money box?
Yes.
Did you deceive your brother?
Yes.
Did you lie to your wife, who by all accounts is a wonderful and supportive woman? Write that down.
Yes, I did all those things.
Which is why I enter a plea of temporary insanity. And before sentencing is pronounced, I think we'd all like to know. What on earth were you thinking?
The learned counselor is right. I did lose my mind. No worse. I lost myself. And it wouldn't have happened if I had just listened. Someone much wiser than me tried to tell me this. Sure as the day follows the night, sure as the sky turns to blue, this much I know, this much is true. above all else in whatever you do. To thine own self be true. Why did I wander so far from the man that the two of you knew I could be? I lost sight of all that mattered somehow. I cannot see it then, but I see it now. I just didn't think I had it in me, so I made it harder than it had to be. Should have followed my heart, should have listened to you. To thine own self be true. To thine own self be true.
Well, that was all very touching. But I'm afraid the law calls for a beheading, and nothing can change that.
Or can it?
What?
The defense calls Master William Shakespeare.
What? Shakespeare!
Hi.
Hi.
How are you? Not you.
How are you?
Good to see you guys! If it please the court.
Oh, the court is very pleased!
Words without thoughts never to heaven go.
I just love how he puts the words out of order like that.
And the quality of mercy is not strained. It droppeth as the gentle rain from heaven.
It entertains as well as educates.
But if a merciful ending is not written here today, then on my stage shall I replay these events with these characters and thee at thy bench. Then shall I see fair justice done.
Are you saying you might write a play about this? With me as a character?
Well, I wouldn't want to look the fool. And you shan't, Lord Falstaff. Not if you spare their lives and see these mischief makers banish
Ed.
Ed.
Send them off this royal throne of kings, this sceptred isle, this blessed plot, this earth, this realm, this...
England.
I agree. That is so much more elegant than beheading. Defendants, I sentence you to be banished.
Ed.
Transported on the third ship to the New World, and take those dreadful musicals with you. Now, Master Shakespeare, my gap.
Oh, look,
the homosexuals! Come back and judge them!
They're gone!
Oh, please. I'm a woman.
You're welcome.
For what? All those lines were from my pages. You just want us out of your way so you can steal my work.
Getting beheaded would have been out of the way as well. No, the world is a better place with you in it. Just not my world. And besides, this amazing woman and impressive actor persuaded me that I can make a stand for free speech today, huh?
I'd say you have about 20 free speeches there.
Oh, Nick, let it go. All's well that ends well.
Hey, good line, Nigel, but what?
Stop giving him your best stuff!
Good night, sweet prince. In flights of angels. Do something.
Nobody's perfect. Exit Shakespeare.
Shakespeare! Nigel!
Portia! Oh, I thought I'd never see you again!
Portia, what are you doing? I thought I sent you away.
Well, and I'm going, but not until I get to say goodbye.
Very well, I'll allow it.
Pains the heart to say adieu to someone you love, but alas, the time has come. Goodbye, Father.
What?
Oh, the good man's children will prosper in the wilderness. Psalms 112. You have your poets and I shall have mine.
Damn it!
Oh my God.
Oh my. So you made a deal with William Shakespeare?
We wanted a new country home. And now we're getting a home. In a new country.
Didn't see that one coming.
I hear... In the new world, a guy like me can be anything he wants.
And I bet they'll be open to some really original ideas.
And brother, I know just the story we should tell.
Ladies and gentlemen, Shylock Entertainment, in association with Pogum Productions, presents the Bottom Brothers in their touching life story.
Who's that coming out of Cornwall with his brother? It's Nick and Nigel Bottom. That started out with nothing but each other. It's Nick and Nigel.
Yes, we are the Bottom Brothers, writing plays just like our mother said we ought to do. We've learned a thing or two.
Almost got us all beheaded.
Sorry.
Instead, we just got finished at it.
Yeah! We came from London on a boat. We landed here and went and wrote a play with songs and dancers galore. Something no one else has ever seen before. So here we go, putting on a show. And not just any old ordinary show. A big and bold extraordinary show. A must-see magical new original musical.
They say it's his masterpiece.
What's it called?
Hamlet.
Oh. Hamlet! I was this close.